Can a water-damaged phone be repaired? Phonebulance.com. Hey guys, welcome back to Phonebulance, and in today's video, we're going to talk about the do's and don'ts when it comes to a water-damaged cell phone. But before we get started, don't forget to smash that subscribe button and ring that notification bell to support amazing content just like this. Okay, let's do this thing. So let me guess, you found your way to Phonebulance because your phone got just a little bit wet. How did it happen? Fall in the toilet? I hope not. Got pushed in the pool? No way. Went for a ride in a dog's slobbering saliva-filled mouth? Rover. Truth is, there are hundreds of ways your precious phone could come in contact with harmful H2O. But don't stress, we've all been there, and it happens to the best of us. Frantically blowing on it while you're freaking out about it is a pretty natural response, but take a chill pill, sit back and relax, as we take a look at today's life-saving video, Can a Water-Damaged Phone Be Repaired? It's no secret that water can cause significant damage to the delicate internal circuitry in an electronic device, even causing catastrophic failure and permanent loss of function. This leaves you with an extremely expensive, inoperable paperweight, or a desk ornament, and your information and data gone for good. Listen carefully as we take you through a comprehensive step-by-step guide to give your poor, saturated companion the best chance of making a full recovery. Troubleshooting. Right, first things first. We have to start off by saying safety first. Do not touch a phone that is wet and plugged into a charger. Okay, with the safety public announcement out of the way, we proceed with the obvious, or for some, not so obvious. Remove the device from the water as quickly as possible. We cannot stress this enough. If possible, also remove the battery immediately. Pulling out the battery in time could make the world of difference in saving your phone from the worst of the damage. Think maimed, not dead. Most phones have a white indicator near the battery that will turn pink or red if water has damaged the phone. Manufacturers will look for this when determining if your device will be covered by warranty or not. Important stuff. You can also try to draw out the moisture by submerging the phone and battery in a bowl of rice or other absorbent material overnight. For best results, use a sealable bag or Tupperware container. Don't laugh, we know that you've heard of this old wives' tale, but it's true. Those old wives, well, they know what's up. The reasoning is the absorbent material surrounding your phone will act like a wick for any moisture trapped within. The liquid will then follow the path of least resistance and, as such, move out of your device and into the permeable contents of the bowl. Thank you, osmosis. Yes, science. You can also try to dry it out with a vacuum cleaner. As long as you don't hold it too close to the device, you'll be fine. Be aware that a hairdryer operating on the cool air setting, even a leaf blower or something similar, is a massive no-no. This will force water deeper into components and circuitry, instead of extracting it, causing even more damage. The theory here is that passing a large volume of air past your soaked circuitry will evaporate dampness as it comes out of your phone. Sometimes cleaning the phone with isopropyl rubbing alcohol will work if it hasn't been exposed to water long. Yeah, we know that sounds insane, but trust us. The isopropyl alcohol is non-conductive and won't damage any circuits. We use it all the time when taking phones and computers apart for deep cleans and repairs. The other added benefit is, as the alcohol dries, it drives the water out along with any trace mineral deposits left behind. These minerals can cause rust and corrosion of components down the line, even after your phone initially starts working again, meaning you may only be giving your phone a temporary new lease on life. Disclaimer though, and we have to mention this for the numbskulls out there, alcohol is extremely flammable and must be treated with the utmost of care, away from naked flames. Other do's and don'ts. Here are some other do's and don'ts to keep in mind when trying to resuscitate that friend that lives in your pocket. Do's. Remove the SIM card, memory card, headphones, and anything else that might be plugged into the device. Dry gently with an absorbent towel to get rid of the bulk of the liquid. Don'ts. Don't push any buttons. This could force water further into the circuits. Don't use a hairdryer on the phone. This could also push water into the phone and do further damage. Don't move the phone more than you have to. It's best to keep the phone still to prevent water from spreading throughout the device. Gravity is not your friend in this case. Don't turn the phone on too soon. It's best to wait 24 hours before attempting to turn your phone back on. Circuits will fry when electricity is flowing over them. Damp electronics can absolutely be saved by being patient, drying properly, and not jumping the gun. Repairing cell phones. If you have tried the advice above without success and your phone is still not working, Let a technician or professional look at your phone. It will surely make every effort possible to salvage your water-damaged phone or other device. However, if the damage is beyond repair, these places have the technology to potentially be able to retrieve any information stored on your phone and transfer it to a new device. Well worth going to the store and trying your luck. And that just about wraps things up for today. We hope we've been able to help. Please like this video and let us know in the comments if you've used any methods discussed in today's video. Did they work? Do you have any others that you may have stumbled across and want to share with us? Remember to smash that subscribe button and share this video if you want more content just like this. See you next time.